Well, good afternoon. It's Monday, August, what's the date today? 23rd, August 23rd, and so I hope you had a good weekend. Sitting here at in my parents' kitchen, doing some relief work for my parents' foster boys. So here staying at the house all week, so that's a good thing. Thought we'd switch up the script a little bit. Instead of last couple weeks we've been in our garage office, and so here we are in the kitchen, and so that's an all right thing. I didn't do it this morning because I just wanted to pray over the topic, but I felt like the Lord wants to talk about this week, creating spiritual momentum. And I was just going to call it creating momentum, but I really felt creating spiritual momentum, because that's really what we want to be about. And you might say, like, why? What's the difference? Well, spiritual momentum is momentum in your relationship with God. It's momentum in your destiny. And everybody has a spirit. You know, some people tell me I'm on the street, or I'm talking to someone and I'm telling them about Jesus, or telling them about the love of God or the cross, and they can be forgiven, and they say, well, you know, I'm spiritual. And I say, well, of course you're spiritual, man. Every person is spiritual. Every person has a spirit. You know, the Bible says in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth, and when he made people, he fashioned Adam out of the dust of the earth, and then breathed life into Adam, breathed life and gave him a spirit. So we have a spirit from God. You know, the book of James, chapter 2, verse 26, says this: just as the body is dead without the spirit, so also faith without is dead without good works, or faith without works is dead. But your body is just a body. You are a spirit. You're a spirit man or a spirit woman, and you have a body, but you're always going to have your spirit. So we need to create spiritual momentum in our relationship with God. One, I'm trying to be just really quick here, as under 5 minutes. That's my goal. So you can just have a good encouragement for the day, and just really, I pray that this would be so impactful. But the first thing that I really had in my heart to spark off this Monday is just to go forward. I mean, I've talked about it before, but if you want to create spiritual momentum, you've got to make a decision to go forward. You've got to make a decision to go forward in your relationship with God, to go forward in your destiny. And I believe God has given you everything you need to go forward. I felt like God dropped on my heart Exodus chapter 14, and this is when the children of Israel were about to cross the Jordan, or the children of Israel were about to cross the Red Sea, rather. And Moses hadn't parted the sea, but, you know, they're all complaining. They're like, why did you take us out here, Moses? We're going to die. We're going to die. I don't know if you've ever been in that type of place of discouragement before, but the enemy's after me. I'm going to die. And Moses told the people in Exodus 14, verse 13, don't be afraid. Just stand still and watch the Lord rescue you today. The Egyptians you see today will never be seen again. The Lord himself will fight for you. Just stay calm. And this is what the Lord said in verse 15. Then the Lord said to Moses, why are you crying out to me? Tell the people to get moving. Another translation, tell the people of Israel to go forward. Go forward through a Red Sea. Pick up your staff and raise your hand over the sea. Verse 16, divide the water so the Israelites can walk through the middle of the sea on the dry ground. And so God, he commands us, why are you crying out to me? Just go forward. Man, woman, I've given you everything you need to go forward. I've given you everything you need to create that momentum and that life flow and that fun and that excitement and that joy in your life. Remember we talked in the first week, there's joy in going forward. There's joy in spiritual growth. Last thing, maybe you're sitting there, and I just feel like a bunch of us are, and we're saying, well, I don't have any of that. I'm not even moving at all. It feels like life is passing me by, and I'm just kind of existing. And it feels so hard to even take that first step. I know it can feel hard, but I want to encourage you with all my heart to pick up and just go forward. This is what the last verse in Proverbs 4, verse 25, it says, look straight ahead, fix your eyes on what lies before you. Mark out a straight path for your feet. Stay on the safe path. Don't get sidetracked. Keep your feet from following evil. And so I just want to encourage you today, as a start to this Monday to do something to go forward. Get out of the rut that you're in. Get out of the place of comfort and apathy that you're in. And take a step of faith. Maybe it's read your Bible. That's a good way to start. Maybe it's take an hour in prayer with the Lord and just spending time with Him. That's a good way to start. But do something to go forward in your relationship with God and start to create a spiritual momentum and a life momentum just in your walk and in your life with God. So God bless you today on this Monday. I hope you have a good Monday, and we'll see you again tomorrow morning.